Dear Unity, wow, today is May the 10th. It's actually Mother's Day. Yeah, it's Mother's Day 2020. It has been an interesting year. Let's just start it off. So, my mom, we went to go. We decided to cater this year on the border because my mom loved Mexican food. I love Mexican food. So, it was a perfect match made in heaven. So, I decided, me and my brother and them decided to pay for the catering. So, we got on the border. My aunt and her kids and, you know, both of my aunties and her kids, which is my cousins and stuff like that, came over. We really did enjoy ourselves overall. It was a good experience. I'm just glad that me and my aunt, my aunt that's close to my age, I'm glad that we're at a better stage than we was a couple of years ago. I'm glad that I have forgiven her for a lot of stuff. I'm glad that she's a changed person, because what she better realize is that I love her so much. We were so close in age, so we really grew up as sisters. She was my protector. She was my number one cheerleader. So it's just good to see we're going, getting back into our space. So I got a call this morning. Everything was going good. I was grateful for waking up this morning. I was grateful for, you know, just being healthy and everything else. And my oldest daughter, London, called me. And she gave me a speech about Mother's Day. And I really enjoyed the speech. It really meant a lot to me. And it's funny because before she could get her speech out, I was up here telling her, like, oh, I thank you. It's been 10 years since I've been a mother, and you was the one who started it off, and I thank you for, you know, allowing me to become mother. And I was just venting and telling her. She's like, I called you for this speech, and you're giving me the speech. So that was kind of funny, but so grateful that she's beautiful, intelligent, and I see a bright future for her. With saying that, I got a call this morning from one of my church members to inform me that a young lady that was a part of my dance group, she had passed away this morning. I'm still in shock, and it's right now, it's hitting me. I just was, you know, in my room a few minutes ago, and I was crying, and, you know, because her mother is so beautiful inside and out. She had three kids like me, two girls, one boy. My kids and her kids is probably around the same ages. And she, single mother, you see what I'm saying? Like, you know, stayed in the same apartments, everything. And her oldest daughter was so sweet, you guys. She was beautiful. Her name was Jayla. She was beautiful inside and out, you know, because I have a dance group called the Divine Angels, and I was just talking to one of the mothers that have three foster kids that are a part of my dance group, and I was just like, even though it's COVID-19, I feel like, you know, I still want to be able to do stuff with them and interact with them, because you just never know. And, you know, they're going to grow up one day. And I always want them to know that, you know, it was something that they was a part of, that they was proud of, which was the dance team. And so as I'm sitting up here thinking, I just want to say thank you, God. I just want to say thank you, God, because the girl was so young. She was beautiful. She had a heart. She had a heart for the Lord. When I tell you, this girl was so, she participated. She used to always be so eager to participate and want to do something for the Lord. I could never forget. She used to be like, you know, like, hey, Miss Quisha, you know, if I said it was a solo, she didn't know how to praise this. But she just was so willing to learn. She was like, I want to do a solo. I don't mind doing a solo when the other girl is kind of shy. She always stepped up to the plate and was willing to do it. She always had that heart and desire. And it's just so sad, because I look at my oldest daughter, and they was around the same age, and I asked God to please please watch over, you know what I'm saying, like, please watch over my kids, because I would hate for the last time that I interact with them be something that I can't control. And my biggest fear is sometimes, I'm not going to lie, that's the biggest fear of any parent. You never want to outlive your kid. You see what I'm saying? But my fear is leaving my kids too soon and they're not able, or they're not equipped to, you know, take care of themselves or to maneuver around the snakes and stuff like that in this thing called life. Because just to be honest with you, it's no one alive that can take your mother's place. You see what I'm saying? Like, it's no, and I just said something about this in my last update, and I was saying it too. I was like, that's crazy, because my kids taught me the definition of unconditional love. A child's love is so pure, and, you know, it hurts, you know what I'm saying? Like, it brings out the worst in people when they have been through something. It's not good. It doesn't feel good. And then I just wanna, I sit back and I just wanna a moment of silence for Chandler, my angel. She was a divine angel, and I appreciate God for placing her in my life and introducing me to a person. That reminds me something of Sister Becky had told me, this lady that goes to my church. And I remember I had stopped dancing because I fell into a depression, you know, having my kid, my first daughter. Dancing was therapeutic to me. It was, it's my life. I love praise dancing because it was kind of like I left everything on the floor, because people say I dance with so much passion. And so I just left it on the floor. I'm like, yes, I'm going to give it my all. People don't know that was therapeutic to me. And I remember stopped dancing after I had my oldest daughter. And I was like, I don't want to dance anymore. And, you know, I don't have a desire for it. And I used to sit down. I just did have her out of wedlock and stuff like that. People would look at me different. That was the enemy talking. So, come down the line, London turns, I say six. She wants to go back to the church, the same church that I started at, which is my grandfather's church. And I haven't been in years, so she didn't even know I was dancing when I was younger. So, long story short, she wanted to do a praise dance. Now, remind you, she never danced a day in her life. She never, you know, knew about the dancing or didn't know nothing. She just knew she wanted to do something for the Lord. So then she tells my uncle, I want to participate. I want to dance. And so he's like, okay. So, he, you know, of course he's like, okay, cool. You know, we need the people. Okay, you fired up. So then I'm looking at her like, oh my God, why would you just volunteer to dance? And so as I began to teach her, I was like, okay, I'm going to teach you a praise dance. I haven't praised dance in so long. I will teach you how to praise dance. So as London dance, London looks at me and she says, Mom, I want you to dance with me. I want my first dance to be with you. This is a 6-year-old, you guys. So I was like, okay, because I'm thinking she nervous or whatever. So I get up there, I dance for London, and Day Day comes. And, everybody in the audience, tears, filled with joy, because before I got up there, I remember kind of telling them, like, I haven't danced. It's crazy how stuff switch around, because I stopped dancing because I had her, and I felt ashamed, and I felt like I was going to be judged, and I feel like, how can I, you know, do something that I love and that made me feel free? So then I turn around, and then this is the same person that uplifts me and encouraged me to go after my dream and to keep dancing and to keep pushing. So just thinking about that being her oldest daughter, and how much light and how smart and beautiful she was, and she was the oldest. That right there alone, you know, I can only imagine what this lady is going through. So I want everybody to keep her in your prayers. Lift her up. you know, like, you know, lift her up, because I don't think a mother will ever be able to let this settle within them, is that their child has passed away, especially on Mother's Day. Mother's Day. So please keep her in prayer. You know, I just, like I said, but say, I do these diaries. This is like a diary to me. So if you ever listening to any of these and you taking out the time to listen to them, this is really not like a podcast. This is just like a diary for me to reflect back on, probably, you know, next year or however long. I just save these and I just basically upload them to YouTube is to share them, you know, so I could probably go back, you know, in the future, you know, in the future, I could go back and be like, well, hey, this is where I was at this time. This is my mindset. This is what I was thinking about. This is what I was going through, because I really don't be feeling like writing down all of this, because sometimes with that writing, my hands get tired. It's another excuse. My hands get tired. I get drowsy. I get sleepy. I start going to take shortcuts on what to say, which when I open up this voice memo and I begin to talk, I can talk freely. You know, like I could just say what I have to say and then I could just press the end button and then upload it versus, you know, and then I could go from there. So I just want to say that on this Mother's Day, I am grateful. I am grateful. I am thankful, you know, for everything, God. Please watch over and pray and uplift Sister Amber. I know she might not understand what is going on. And I know this might put a damper on her heart for the rest of her life. I know it is. But please let her know, God, that you are still there for her through her time of darkness. Yes, and you are still there for her no matter what. Please keep her mind and her body strong for her other two younger kids. Lord Jesus, I know you can do it. And I'm just going to leave on that note. Love, peace, and unity. Be blessed.